First of all, thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. So in this lesson number 6 on the topic number system, now we are going to learn one of the most important concepts called converting a decimal number into a fraction numbers. So friends, listen here, this number system topic is a basics of complete quantitative aptitude. So always start learn from lesson number 1. So only then you will feel easy about this number system topic. So friends, here in the exams, how they usually ask a question is they will give us some sort of number like this, 0.12 bar. So our target is to convert this decimal number in terms of fractions. For example, 9 by 12, 13 by 14, 96 by 102, like that. So our target is to convert the decimal numbers into fraction. So when you take a decimal numbers, there are two types of decimal numbers. So here I have given model 1 and model 2. So just see here, model number 1, the value is 0.12. So our target is to convert this decimal number into a fraction. Model number 2 is 0.12 bar. So what does it bar denotes? You know what is called as a bar? Usually in the most of the exams, you can able to see 0.6 bar. So it means if they have given a bar to any number, it means 0.6, the exact answer is 0.666, it goes on. It does not have an end. So that's the reason they are writing this number as 06 bar. Got it or not? Similarly, if they have given a bar like 0.23 bar. So this bar is for both the numbers, 23. So the meaning is the exact answer will be 0.23, 23, 23, it goes on. Got it, does not have an end. So they can't able to write like this. That's the reason how they simply write this as 0.23 bar. Got it? So these types of questions are called as model number 2. Friends, listen here, this model number 1 question is very easy to convert into fraction. Why? Because you can see 0.12, right? So this can be written as 12 divided by 100, yes or no, right? Because you can able to see after decimal point we have two value. So in order to remove the decimal point divided by 100, if you cancel it on 4 table, so 3 divided by 25. So finally, answer for this first question is 3 divided by 25. If you check this value in the calculator, 3 divided by 25, you will get the answer as 0.12. So converting these types of questions into a fraction is very, very simple. You don't want to work hard because you don't have any shortcuts or nothing. You can just like that, you can divide by 100 or divide by 1000 based on the question and you will get the fraction. But for these cases, you have to learn some of the types. Only then you can able to solve the question. So now in this video, we are going to learn how to convert the decimal to fraction, that is for model number 2 question. In case if you don't know how to solve this model number 1 question, I will teach you on 10th lesson or 11th lesson. It is very simple. Even the kids can able to solve this. So that's the reason I'm not going to concentrate this model 1. So where in most of the exams you can able to see, many questions will be asked only in model 2. So how to convert the 0.12 bar, these types of questions, into a fraction. So that's the thing we are going to learn in this lesson number 6. Got it? So let me move on to all the model and all the type of questions in model number 2. So now let me discuss some of the types that are in model number 2. So friends, here you know how the model number 2 question looks like. For some numbers, they will give you a bar. It is called as model number 2. So here in this model number 2 category decimal values, we have three type of question. So type 1, type 2 and type 3. So first, before solving a question, we can learn what is the major difference between type 1, type 2 and type 3. So listen here friends, type number 1 and type number 2, you can able to see the starting number is 0.0.0. But type number 3, you can able to see the starting number is 5.21 or 2.96 point something. So this is the major difference between type 1, 2 and for type 3. Got it or not, right? So you can able to see type number 3, where the starting number will be some sort of numbers. Example, not 0. Other than 0, there will be some numbers which is called as type number 3. So now the difference between type 1 and type 2 is, in type number 1, here the decimal value is 0.93. For both the numbers, you can able to see there is a bar. But here in type number 2, 0.48, but for this 0.48, they have given a bar only for the number 8, not for number 4. Got it or not? So this is the difference between type 1 and type 2. So see here, 0.631. So here for all the numbers, they have given a bar. But in type number 2, for only 2 numbers, they have given a bar and not for 6. So this is called as type number 2. So friends, understood or not? What is the major difference between type 1, type 2 and type 3? So type 3 is completely different, where the starting number will be other than 0, which is called as type number 3. So the difference between type 1 and type 2 is, in type number 1, where for all the given decimal numbers, they will be given a bar at the top, which is called as type 1. For some numbers, after the decimal point, there will not be bar. For some numbers, right? It is called as type number 2. Got it? So every time in the exams, while seeing a question, first decide which type of question it is and then try to solve the question, so that it will be easy. Without any mistake, you can able to solve the question. So now let me solve all the questions in type 1, type 2 and type 3. So here is type number 1, question 3 questions I have taken. So we are going to solve this 3 questions. So our target is what? To convert this decimal value into a fraction term. So first, the easiest way is, just see here, 0.4 bar. So for this number 4, we have a bar, right? So first, what you need to do is write down 4 as it is. Got it? So divided by, because of a bar, in order to remove this bar, I'm writing as 9. Got it? So finally, answer for this question number 1 is 4 by 9. Got it or not? It is very easy. Just check in the calculator. Go to the calculator. If you have calculator, just check and verify whether you are getting the answer or not. So 4 divided by 9. If you divide 4 divided by 9, you will get an answer as 0.444 something. So finally, we have converted this value into a fraction. So how we have converted? First, write the number as it is. So divided by, because of this bar, in order to remove this bar, you have to put 9 in the denominator. In case, if there are 2 numbers, the bar is for 2 numbers, just listen carefully, write the 93 number as it is. So divided by, for one number bar, 9. Got it? For another number bar, 9. So 99. So finally, answer for this question will be 93 divided by 99. If you want, you can cross check in the calculator. So 93 divided by 99, if you cross check the answer in the calculator, you will get 0.939393. It goes on. So that's the reason they are saying 0.93 bar. Got it or not, right? For one number bar, you have to, in order to remove that bar, divided by 9. If there are 2 numbers, divided by 99. If there are bar has been given for 3 numbers, what do you need to do? So 631 divided by 999. Got it? That's it. So fine. If you want, you can reduce it. If you cancel this on 3 table, it becomes 31 by 33. Yes, you can. If you can able to cancel the numbers, yeah, you can able to cancel the numbers. Got it? But actually, the final answer should be in terms of fraction. So if you have a doubt, you can cross check with the calculator, so that you will you can able to verify it, whether we are getting the answers or not. Got it? So finally, type number 1 questions are easy. If they have given a bar for all the numbers, so check how many numbers are there. If it is one number, divided by 19. If there are 2 numbers, divided by 29. If there are 3 numbers, divided by 39. If there are 5 numbers, divided by 59. That's it. So this is the way we have to convert the decimal value in terms of fraction for this type number 1 question. So now we can solve 3 questions from type number 2. So type number 2 is what? For some numbers, there will not be any bar at the top of the number, right? Which is called as type number 2. So just see here, they have given the first question as 0.43 bar. And for the bar is given only for 3. So first step, what you need to do is write down 43 as it is. Got it? Second step, in the previous question, the previous model, for both the numbers we have bar. So we have written divided by 99. But here in this question, for the number 4, there is no bar given at the top. So what you need to do is subtract 4 with the number. Got it? 43 minus 4 divided by, just listen carefully. For one bar, in order to remove one bar, we will do denominator as 9. Yes or no? You will write denominator 9. For the number which does not have any bar, write denominator as 0. Got it? So finally, 43 minus 4 will be 39 divided by 90. So this will be the answer for question number 1. You can cross check with the calculator whether we are getting this answer or not. So friends, got it? What I did is, initially write down the number 43 as it is, minus of, where, for which number they have not given the bar, right? For number 4, there is no bar. So subtract with the number, 43 minus 4. You should write in the numerator. Divided by, for one bar, in order to remove the bar, denominator 9. For the number which does not have a bar, divided by 0. So 90, that's it. Got it or not, right? So next question, 0.48. What you need to do? So first write down 48 as it is. For the number 4, we don't have any bar at the top. So subtract that number with this number. So divided by, for one bar number 9. So the number which does not have bar is one number. So for, in order to remove that, so 0. Got it? So 90. 48 will be 44 divided by 90. If you want, you can cancel this on two table. So finally, answer for this question. We have converted this decimal number into fraction. That is 44 by 90. So last number, 0.633 bar. So what you need to do? First write down 633 as it is. Minus of 6. Got it or not, right? For this number 6, we don't have any bar at the top. So we have to subtract 6 here. So divided by, for 2 bar, 99. Got it? For one number which does not have a bar, is 0. So finally, 630 will be 627 divided by 990. Got it? So finally, this will be the fraction for question number 3. That's it. So this is the difference between type 1 and type 2. So now we can solve 3 questions from type number 3. So if you learn type 1 and type 2, type number 3 is very simple. But only a few changes you have to make before solving the question. Just see here, the first question is 5.21. First, what you need to do is, you convert this number as 5 plus 0.21. Got it or not, right? How I am writing this? Just see here, if you add 5 plus 0.21 bar, resultant answer is what? 5.21 bar, yes or no? Now keep the number 5 as it is. For this 0.21 bar alone, you can find the answer easily, because 0.21 is type 1 or type 2. For both the numbers, they have given a bar, which is type number 1. So this can be written as 21. In order to remove the bar, 99. So if you cross multiply it, 5 into 99 plus 21, resultant will be 516 divided by 99. Got it? So if you cross check with the calculator, you will get the answer as 5.21 bar. 5.212121, it goes on. So finally, we can say that 5.21 bar. Easy or not? Very simple, friends. All the 3 models will be very simple. And type number 3 alone, you have to make small changes before solving the question. The change is, if they have given us 5.21 bar, first what you need to do is write this as 5 plus 0.21 bar. So keep the number 5 as it is, and find for the answer for, by using type 1 and type 2, find answer for the second term, and finally cross multiply and find the answer, right? 99 into 5 plus 21, so divided by 99. So let me move on to another example question. So 2.12 bar. So what you need to do is, first write this as 2 plus 0.12 bar. Understood or not? So the bar they have given for only one number, that is for 2. So next step, 2 plus, whether it is type 1 or type 2, it is type number 2. Why? Because for some numbers, they have not given any bar. So what you need to do? So write down 12 as it is, subtract with the number they have not given any bar. So 1 divided by, for 1 bar, 9. For one number which does not have a bar, which is 0. So now this can be written as 2 plus 11 divided by 90. So now cross multiply it, 180, 191. Divided by 90. So this will be the answer for second question. So friends, understood how I wrote this? So listen here, first 2.12 bar I have written as 2 plus 0.12 bar, and now keep the number 2 as it is. You don't want to change any values, so concentrate on the second term. So second term is type number 2, right? According to type number 2, we subtract with the number which does not have a bar. So 12 minus 1 divided by 90. So after finding the answer, cross multiply and add with 11. Resultant will be the final answer. Got it? So next step, last question. So 96.16 bar. So the bar is given only for the number 6, right? So first what you need to do is, you write this as 96 plus 0.16 bar. Got it? So keep the number 96 as it is, whether it is type 1 or type 2, type number 2. Got it? What you need to do is write 16 here, subtract with 1, so divided by, for 1 bar, 9. For one number which does not have a bar, which is 0. So 96 plus 15 divided by 90. So if you multiply it, resultant will be 0. 96 are 54, 5. 99s are 81. 81 plus 5 will be 86. So plus 15 divided by 90. So finally 8655 divided by 90. So this will be the fraction for the third question. So friends, finally in this video we have learned three type of question in this converting decimal to fraction. So all the three models is very simple and easy. So you have to understand that concept alone. So what shortcut we have used in order to convert into fraction. So for type number one, for some bars, right, if all the numbers they have given a bar, so instead of bar we have written denominator as 99. For type number two, for some numbers the bar has been not given, for those numbers we have written 0 at the denominator. And type number 3 is completely different. Initially we will make some changes in the question and then everything is same according to type 1 and type 2. So got it friends? So that's it about this lesson number 6. So after watching this video, so try to solve, search in Google, you will get many questions. So try to solve all the questions as much you can, only then you can able to solve the questions in your exams. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you really like it, share the video to your friends, those who are preparing for the competitive exams. So thank you so much for watching it. Bye.